This is like the ultimate bootleg movie. It's official, but it has that feel of like really being there and like, you know, there's a brain behind it, but it feels like it's...
Love that.
It's what, I mean, and the device you use of showing the nine cameras at the same time is kind of like so current in a way. It's like what people are thinking, and then you move away from that. It's kind of a fascinating film.
Well, you know, this film was 98% intended to be, or hoped to be, a response to the meticulousness of Heart of Gold, which
really?
Was a, you know, we just lavished meticulousness on that film, and mm-hmm. to great results. You know, we designed it mm-hmm. in every way, and this one we didn't want to design anything in the hopes of stumbling into a real rock and roll film,
mm-hmm.
and Bootleg is perfect.
Well, it feels like, because you use different formats, right? You use how many different
yes.
formats at the same time?
Well, we had primarily digital,
uh-huh.
but we shot Super 8, and we even rolled some 35 millimeter every once in a while. And we also had these little tiny Icon cameras. Do you know about them?
No.
They're the size of a cigarette pack.
Huh.
And Declan Quinn attached some of these
mm-hmm.
To a couple of little positions just as an experiment.
Right.
One of them he attached to the top of one of the cymbal stands
mm-hmm.
pointing out at the stage.
Hmm.
Another he kind of put attached to the corner of the piano.
Mm-hmm.
Just see what we come up with. And the especially the cymbal
right.
angle resulted in these amazingly intimate mm-hmm. moments when Neil comes to the drums
mm-hmm.
for one reason or another.
So you and Declan are like completely kind of just go for it now?
Oh, yeah. You know, when you've got an eye like his,
mm-hmm.
it's absurd to do anything else. I just love working with him. That said,
mm-hmm.
Just lately, now that we've done three complete shoot from the hip pictures in a row,
right.
I'm finding myself thinking how nice it would be to design something with Declan as well, because
mm-hmm.
he's done masterful work in that area too, as we've seen with Mira Nair films and all kinds of stuff. But yeah, with him, his instincts are just unbelievable, and they're a passport into total freedom for me.
So how long did you work on, and what kind of pre-production do you do on a picture like this?
None. You know, we showed up the night before or something,
mm-hmm.
Because it was so beautifully lit by Peggy Eisenhower, the stage
mm-hmm.
show. And again, with digital,
right.
you just don't have to enhance the lighting.
Mm-hmm.
In fact, as you know, if anything, digital shows you more information than you'd actually like to see.
Mm-hmm.
You know, we went for, unfortunately, when you go online, you can then hopefully
right.
readjust to the magic of what it was in the room or
right.
at the sunset. So we did very, very, very little lighting work.
Mm-hmm.
And we were working utterly with Neil's sound team. In fact, the mix of the film with a couple of tiny little tweaks, but
mm-hmm.
but what the sound that accompanies this movie is what was heard in the room during that show. It's the soundboard mix.
So is it just getting that much easier to make a movie? I mean, is that part of the experience for you?
Well, that stuff worked. That was just so right,
right.
for this one. Because we, you know, I love that you said bootleg. I haven't thought that word, but it is that you come in and you grab the experience,
mm-hmm.
and then you run away with it.
And you really have the experience. I mean, that's the thing that's so. I mean, I love your concert films, but this one has a rawness to it that really feels like that. You know, when you're jostling around with a crowd on a floor, and you know, trying to figure out, and you're running around, and sometimes leaving to go get a drink or whatever.
Right.
You know, it feels like that. It has that energy in the room.
Good, good, good. You know, the whenever you do a performance film, you edit to the board mix.
Right.
But you always then go on to a movie mixing stage,
mm-hmm.
and you start all over again. You have the isolated tracks, and you create a mix,
mm-hmm.
and then you play it for Neil, and Neil does his version of that mix, and then finally that's what you send to the laboratory. And halfway through the editing of this film, I started feeling, you know, this mix, this raw, unnuanced sound is mm-hmm. part of what's making these visuals so kind of perfect. Mm-hmm. And I started getting nervous about what was going to happen there. And then when Elliot Roberts heard that, he was mm-hmm. like, well, there's nothing in the budget for a movie mix anyway. So I was like, well,
he's over there counting money right now.
Perfect then. Forgive me, I thought you'd left. He didn't really. But that's true. And then the other thing was, and I'll say the same thing, was that what we were working with was the uncolor corrected dailies. Mm-hmm. And with the different textural imbalances, I came to be thinking mm-hmm. part of the excitement, part of what helps us get so lost and inside this music is the way it looks now. Mm-hmm. I don't want to go online and match everything up. And Elliot said, good, because we don't have any money for onlining. And that's true. And we didn't. Mm-hmm. We still don't.
Everyone has to know everything.